has meaning, where there's feedback from, say, adult to youth and youth to adult, that we're going to be missing the boat in any educational program. Where did this need for stimulation come from? And remember the key word, stimulation, which is opposite to boredom. And if there's any common phrase used as to why youngsters are taking drugs or doing the more bizarre or way out things, it is that they are bored.
An amphetamine researcher.
Well, if you're talking about the use of amphetamines intravenously, I think there are two drug effects which are important. Number one is the immediate effect of the drug, that is the flash or the rush, which is in many ways similar to a total body orgasm. And a lot of people who use amphetamines use them primarily for the flash or rush, or this very delightful feeling that one initially has. Secondly, there's a long-range stimulative effect where one feels euphoric, very confident of his abilities. He feels that he's able to think very quickly, that he's very perceptive. In some cases, if used over a long period of time, the amphetamines become almost psychedelic in effect. And finally, there's the kind of lifestyle that one gets caught up in, namely the total involvement in using and procuring amphetamines, and in a sense his life becomes very similar to the kind of life that a heroin addict leads, that he is totally consumed with the use and obtaining of drugs, and his friends are involved in the drug scene, and there's a certain excitement and challenge about that whole scene that is very attractive to some people.
A minister.
Some kids are misusing drugs because they've got a pretty distorted picture of who they are. They're healthy kids. They've got a lot to go going for them in terms of their ability to study, to relate, to be free. But for some reason, that's not the way they see themselves. That may be the way the world views them, but that's not the way they see themselves. And so they continue in their drug abuse to cope with a kind of an unhappy world. I counsel a girl now, for instance, who every Sunday night becomes very nervous, very anxious. She's very uptight. She is trying to prepare herself for facing school on Monday. Now, this girl is, in the best sense of the word, beautiful. And I don't mean just physically. She's really great. She's comes from a pretty solid family. She's got tremendous potential. She's open and free. She laughs, but she feels rejected. Now, in some ways, she's trying to handle a social kind of problem, which, by any objective measure, really does not exist. But it's a way of coping. And drugs accomplish a great deal in a short period of time. She takes barbiturates almost exclusively, Reds or Seconal, and it allows her just to back off from the pain of what she feels is rejection. So those who I think stay with it are people who are trying to cope with kind of a negative self-image, whether it's real or imaginary. Mm-hmm. I always qualify that because I don't like to generalize. Not all users are escapists. Not all of them are clamoring after a crutch of some sort. But some, those that act out in extreme fashion, are people that are hurt people. And this is their way of kind of pulling back into a corner and saying, well, at least I've got this thing. This is my bag.
A superintendent of schools.
The people in our district who have spent a great deal of time talking with young people tell me that the young people continually say that there is a breakdown in communication with the parents, that the parents either are not interested in listening, or that they don't have the time to listen, or that they don't care. The fact that their parents may be over-involved in work or in various other activities which they may have. This is the sort of feedback that we get.
We talked with two men of widely different experience. One, Dr. Stephen Patel, works in a research project in Haight-Ashbury. The other, Don McCune, is a director of instruction in a middle-class school system. It is interesting how their comments reinforce each other.
Drugs. The young people that are using the drugs come from every walk of life. The old stereotype that only the bad kids from bad environments and bad homes are the drug users just doesn't hold true anymore. We're quite sure now that the drug problem goes through our society from one continuum to the other. Those who are economically well off, those who are economically poor, and all those in between, those who come from the good parts of town, quote, and the bad parts of town, everyone, there is no one that escapes it.
They come from very diversified backgrounds, from middle-class families, lower-class families, even a number of upper-class families. Geographically, they come from all over the United States.
The peer group pressure that our young people are under today, the desire to be with the group, to be one of them, is certainly a very key factor in their turning to the use of drugs.
And I guess the only thing that they have in common is their failure to find some sort of identity in any previous environment that they've been in. They feel that they are more at home with the people who are here in the Haight-Ashbury, who are using drugs, and they feel that they can communicate better with others who use drugs.
Young people in school today are being asked to perform at levels which we seriously doubted were possible in years before. So therefore, we're having emotional pressures on our young people. And some of them are turning to drugs to escape. Others are turning to drugs to turn on instead of turning off, to become stimulated. They seek excitement, and psychologically they're somewhat unstable and turn to the use of drugs to do this.
They are often lonely, sometimes confused, and often very idealistic young people who are trying to find some meaning in life through the hippie culture and through the use of drugs.
Young, sensitive, bored, maladjusted, searching, or curious, children are attracted to drug experimentation in a drug-oriented society. Ours is not the first culture to grapple with the attractiveness of drugs, but rarely has a culture focused this kind of attention on the issue. This series will look at the most basic of these issues. The children are choosing.
I believe that in education, we are obligated to give these young people the knowledge so that they can make a proper decision. We know that the decisions that are being made by young people are made when we're not there to help them. So therefore, we must prepare them to make these decisions. And if we believe in education, then we must believe in knowledge and the knowledge that helps them make these decisions. Now it's your time, or if it's run down, can't seem to catch a beat off the ground. Maybe you ought to try a little bit of LSD, only if you want to.